With you today to teach you about how to be successful in life and with yourself.
All right, hello. Welcome to Strokes of Success. Here I've got my little design. Little girl riding a horse. I'm just kind of laying her in here. Just sketching, laying some lines so I know the approximate placement of where I'm going to be painting what. I don't want to get too dark with my lines because the paint will pick it up, especially on the white. The highlights through here, the highlights through here, that will all be picked up by the paint, so you have to be careful that it doesn't intermix. The darker things, like the horse's ear here, that's alright. Here's a little eye, that's alright. Here's a little nostril. Here's a little mouse. Make him a happy little horse. He's a happy little horse. You would be too if you had the life he has. He probably eats better than 90% of the world. And better than 90% of America. Gauging by his nice coat and his plump little tummy. Here's his little tummy. Goes up into here. Here's his big tummy. Here's a nice little tummy. He's exercised regularly. He's given a nice healthy diet. But he's just a phony. Begins that. Alright. Bring this down into her hand. Her shirt goes out here. And for the background, let's put a little bit of a tail in. More of this leg. We don't have to do anything in the background because we can do whatever we want. No rules. Bushes and trees and shrubs have any shape you want to give them. But a little girl and a horse should have a specific shape, lest they become abstract and who knows what. Alright, now we're going to begin with putting in some of our darks. We're going to get a rather large brush. This is a 5. Now, of course, that's too big for the horse, but he's fine for the background. But first, I want to lay in some colors for the horse. That will determine the background. So I'm going to drop down. We've got this, and I've got my glaze. A little bit of glaze, which is a secret recipe that I learned in Italy. So I've got my glaze, which I load my brush up with, and I take tick, a brown. And now I'm adding crimson alizarin to a little bit of raw sienna to give me this color of brown. And as you can see, the horse is much darker than that, but I'm not following the colors of the picture. I'm going by my gut. And I'm just going to lay this in here real fast. Again, pick up some glaze. This is going to pull it through. Now that's way too light, because I want some strong shadows and lights in here. And in order to get stronger lights, you go darker with the darks or lighter with the lights or both. This is just getting my outline going here. So I'm going to go darker. I'm going to add some green to bring my brown into a darker color. You can see what that's going to do. That's going to turn it into a richer brown, darker brown. Anytime you add the complementary, the opposite of the color, you always go darker. You end up with brown. Purple and yellow, brown. Blue and orange, brown. The only time that law doesn't work is when you're adding white to black, and you get gray. So now I'm doing this as a light glaze almost, because I don't want to go too thick with my paint yet. I'm just laying things out. As I get bolder painting on camera, I'll go more into my loading the brush up with paint like I normally do. But right now, it's been 3 years since I've actually painted, so you're witnessing me painting before you for the first time in 3 years. So bear with me. Again, more green. And now don't be afraid to add a splash of green, to really go bold. It doesn't have to be perfect brown, perfect colors, lining up with the photograph or the image you're painting. You are the artist. You can create anything you want. The rules are whatever you make them to be. And I find some of the most interesting paintings that I paint, I break the rules. I'll add magenta or cerulean blue or something wild, and you get a beautiful result, as long as you don't go too crazy off the deep end. So it's fun, and it's good to experiment and keep pushing the envelope. It's not about turning out the painting, it's about the process of learning how to paint. Just like anything else in life, it's the journey, it's what you learn along the way. You see, most people think life is about just getting somewhere. You get an education so that you can get a job and get somewhere, and that's not what it's about. It's along the way. Who are you? Are you a different person now? Are you a better person? You have more wisdom, more joy. Is there meaning in your life, or have you just gone through life with your eyes closed, just waiting for the paycheck and for another movie? It's time to take action with your life. Enjoy everything that you do. Life is short. You can get it if you really and I know too many people, they hit 80 years old or 60 years old, and they look back and they feel like their life is over, and that they haven't done anything with it. They haven't fully lived it. They haven't fully done anything. All they did is work, and they found out that that was it. It was empty. Be bold with your colors, with your life. Take a chance. Go after a dream. The worst thing that could happen is you fail. And you know what? The greatest men in the world all failed before they achieved greatness. And you only truly fail when you stop trying. So keep painting. Keep trying. Keep doing whatever it is. Take a break if you have to, but get up. Try it again. Try it again. Try it again. Don't stop.
Try and try, you'll succeed at last. I know it. Listen, Rome was not built in a day. Opposition will come your way, but the harder the battle. see that land.